In the previous video, we saw the mole fraction, molality, molarity calculations. In this one, I'll try to do some problems based on previous equations so that we can practice them. Okay. So the first one I have is asked two times, 2011 and 2015. What is the mole fraction of a solute in a 1 molal aqueous solution? So I have 1 molal aqueous solution. They are asking you what is the mole fraction of the solute. Okay. So now what I have is, I have 1 molal solution, which is nothing but moles of B divided by kilogram of A. Okay. We can take it as 1 molal, meaning 1 moles of B in 1 kilogram of A. This is what 1 molal means, 1 mole in 1 kilogram of A. So I have 1 moles of B in 1 kilogram of A. Now chi B is moles B divided by moles A plus moles B. So I have moles B, I need to calculate moles A. Moles of A, I need to calculate this. I have mass of A, how do you calculate moles? Okay. Now here aqueous, the solvent is water, molar mass is 18 gram per mole. Right, so now moles of A is mass of A divided by molar mass of A. Straightforward. Now mass of A is 1 kilogram, which is 1000, divided by molar mass of A is 18. And I always tell my students, this particular number you have to know, it is 55.55. This number you want to know, it is a repetitive question. Okay, 55.55. So now what I have is chi B equals moles of B, which is 1, divided by 1 plus 55.55, which is 1 by 56.55, right? So now approximately, this is the way to do, approximately this is 1 by 50, okay? So 1 by 50, you can take it as 100 times 10 power minus 2, right? 1 is 100 times 10 power minus 2 divided by 50. So that's going to be equal to 2 times 10 power minus 2 or 0.02, right? So now if I do 1 by 50, I get 0.02. I divide it by a little bit larger number, I get something that is smaller than this. This is 10%, close to 10%. 56.55 and approximate to 50, that's about 10%. Okay, I'm dividing by a number that is 10% low. Okay, so the number that I get is actually bigger than what I should have got. So it just decreased 10% here, 0.018, something like this. Good thing about these competitive exams, they don't give you answers close enough. So now what all answers you have is alpha is 1.77. Now right away I can say it is wrong, mole fraction is never more than 1. B is 0.0354, C is 0.0177, our answer. D is 0.177, that's pretty much it. Okay, this is 2015-2011, that's been asked, and this comes in many questions. Going to the next question, how many grams of concentrated nitric acid, okay, how many grams of concentrated nitric acid should be used to prepare 250 mils of 2 molar nitric acid solution? The concentrated acid is 70%. So how many grams of concentrated nitric acid should I be using? Okay, this is 70% pure. I need to prepare 250 mils of 2 molar. Okay, this is what I need to prepare. So now we know that moles equals molarity times volume, correct? Molarity is 2 times volume is 0.250, because this has to be in liters, this is in milliliters. So if you use this in milliliters, you would get millimoles, still okay. Now 2 times 0.25, so this would be 0.50 moles. Okay, so what is the weight of H2SO4 that will correspond to 0.50 moles? Moles equals mass over molar mass, so this would be 0.50 times molecular mass of H2SO4, right? Molecular mass of H2SO4, you shouldn't calculate in the exam, most of them they will give you, but I want you guys to remember it, okay? So H2SO4, okay, sulfur is 32. This is 4 times 16, this is 2 times 1, okay. Now you can calculate it yourself. 4 times 16 would be 64, 32, 2. So what do you end up getting? 98. And you want to remember that 98 gram per mole, okay. So 98 times 0.50, that will be around 49 grams. So this is the weight of H2SO4 I need to take, right? But they are telling me the sample that I have is only 70% pure. So weight of impure sample would be, how much I need to take is 49 grams times 100 by 70, okay. So now if you see, okay, now let's look at the numbers that are given. So they given you alpha, 70 grams of corn H2SO, HNO3, 54 grams, 45 grams, 90 grams, pretty much straightforward. Now the 54, 45, 90, they all come from common mistakes that people make. So this is again straightforward, just math, but I don't cancel my numbers anywhere until the end, they will cancel. Concentrated aqueous sulfuric acid is 98% H2SO4 by mass. The values that are given to you. Now what do you want to do is, there is a shortcut formula here. Molarity of a solution, okay, molarity of a solution is density times percent purity times 1000 divided by molecular mass times 100, okay. This is molarity in moles per liter. So my density is 1.80 gram per mil, okay, times percent purity is 98% times 1000 divided by molecular weight. So your molecular weight is going to be, for sulfuric acid we know that it is going to be 98 gram per mole, okay, times 100. Now if you see, gram goes away, denominator goes to the numerator, so I have moles per mil. Okay, this is percent purity, 98 by 100 is percent. Now I have moles per mil, but I want moles per liter. To take care of that is why you have 1000 here. Now when you look at it, so if you look at this, I have 1.8 times 10 is 18 molar. Okay, now it becomes very, very straightforward. Now basically I have this solution, I want to prepare this solution, meaning dilution. For dilution, we have M1V1 equals M2V2. Doesn't matter which one you take as M1, which one you take as M2, right? I'm going to take this as M1, it's just easier. So V1 equals M2V2 by M1. Okay. My M2 is 0.1 times V2 is 1 liter divided by 18. Okay. So now this is nothing but V1 equals 1 divided by 180, okay, this is liters, that's nothing but 1000 divided by 180 milliliters. 1000 divided by 200 is 5. So I have approximated this number as a bigger number, 180, instead of 180 I use 200, so the number I got is smaller, but I'm supposed to get bigger. 180 and 200 are differing by a factor of 10. So this would be 5.5 milliliters. Now let's look at the options that have been given. So they have given you 16.65, 22.2, 5.55 milliliters or 11.010 milliliters. Okay. The next one we are going to look into is a solution containing 10 grams per decimeter cube of urea. 10 grams per decimeter cube is nothing but 10 grams per 1 liter. Okay, decimeter cube is 1 liter of urea, molecular mass is 60. You want to remember urea molecular mass, it's a recurring example, is isotonic with 5% solution of 5 non-volatile solute. Okay. 5% solution of
5% solution of non-volatile solute. Now we have not seen solutions chapter yet, okay, but still I put this question so just so that you get used to this one. 5% solution of non-volatile solute is nothing but 5 grams of B in 100 grams of S. That's what a 5% percent of solution. Now generally what you can take it is, this is approximately equal to 5 grams of B in 100 milliliters of S, assuming density is 1. Because it's a dilute solution, it's okay, you can assume the density is 1. So that tells you this is nothing but 50 grams of B in 1 liter of solution. Why I do that is, now I can actually calculate molarity of this solution would be moles B divided by volume of solution. Moles B is nothing but mass B divided by molecular mass B divided by volume of solution. Mass B is 50 grams, molecular mass B is of that of urea divided by gram per mole volume of solution. Okay, volume of solution I conveniently converted into 1 liter, so it doesn't matter, this is 1. So I have 50 by 60 or 5 by 6 moles, sorry, molarity of urea. Now I have molarity here, I have grams per liter, grams can be converted to moles, moles per liter. So I have molarity and molarity comparison. So it's a lot easier. I just wanted to choose this problem at this point to show you how to use a 5% solution converted to molarity. The next we are going to see is 2.5 liters of 1 molar NaOH is mixed with another 3 liters of 0.5 molar NaOH, then find out the molarity of the resultant solution. So 2.5 liters of 1 molar is mixed with liters of 0.5 molar. Okay, what is the final? So now when you add these two, they are both NaOH, when you add these two they are not going to react. So moles are additive, they add up. So what you need to do is, moles final is moles 1 plus moles 2. Okay, so moles final is moles 1 plus moles 2, molarity final is moles final by volume final, correct? Molarity is moles over liters, moles final by volume final. Okay, so that will be equal to moles 1 divided by moles 2 divided by volume final. What is moles 1? Molarity times volume. So V1 M1 plus V2 M2 is N1 plus N2 divided by VF. Okay. In our case what we have is 2.5 times 1 plus 3 times 0.5 divided by, what is the final volume? 2.5 plus 3. So this is 2.5 plus 3 times this is 1.5 divided by 3 plus 2.5 is 5.5. So this is 4 divided by 5.5. Right. Now you can look into what is the answer that is closest. So now they have given you 0.8, 0.73, 1.5. Now how you can do it is, if you want, you can take it as 40 times 10 power minus 1 divided by 5 approximately. Okay, I have decreased it 10 times. So this would be 8. So this is 0.8. So the value is going to be about 10 times less, because I divided by a smaller number. Had I divided by a larger number, this value would be smaller. So 10% approximation, 10% less. So approximately equal to 0.72, 0.8 minus 0.08. So I have 0.73 as your answer. Our next question, how many grams of dibasic acid? Grams of dibasic acid. Dibasic means 2H plus can be donated. Of acid should be present in 100 mils of aqueous solution to give a strength of 0.1 normal. 0.1 normal, 100 mil. Okay, so this is what we have. It's a dibasic acid. So molarity, okay, is normality divided by
n factor.
N factor for this is basically the number of replaceable hydrogen atoms, 2 H plus is there. So basically n
divided by 2, 0.1 divided by 2. I'm going to leave it as it is. This is the molarity.
Now they are asking you grams.
Okay, they have given you molecular weight is 200. So now moles equals mass over molar mass.
Sorry,
moles equals in this case molarity times volume. Molarity is 0.1 divided by 2. Volume is 100 mils. 100 mils is 0.1 liters. Okay. So now what we have is 10 power minus 1, 10 power minus 1 is 10 power minus 2 divided by 2. This is 5 times 10 power minus 3 moles.
Right.
Now finally they ask you what is the weight. Weight is moles times molar mass. So moles is 5 times 10 power minus 3 times molar mass given as 200. 10 power minus 1. Okay. 5 times 2 is 10. 10 times 10 power minus 2 is 1. So 1 gram.
Right? Straightforward.
Okay. Last question. How many grams of methanol should be added to water to prepare 150 mils of
2 molar solution? How many grams should be added?
So always you go through moles. Moles equals molarity times volume. Our molarity is 2 times volume is 0.150. This is in milliliters. This is this. 2 times 0.150 is 0.3 moles. Now how many grams? Weight equals moles times molecular mass.
Right.
They don't give you here, so you have to calculate it. Methanol. So this is 12. This is 1. This is 16. So I have 12 plus 4 hydrogens plus 1 oxygen, 16. So 20, 32. So moles is 0.3 times 32.
Alright.
So this is straightforward. You're going to have 9.6 grams methanol. Now the options are very, very straightforward. Just watch out for whether they are asking you grams, milligrams, or kilograms. They are asking you grams, you got your answer right. Okay. These are the basic fundamental questions for mole concept related to solutions chapter. We'll be doing the previous year problems completely as always. I'll post it as a separate video. I would advise you guys to pause the video every time I start with a question. Solve it yourself if you can. Check the answer. If it's new for you, listen to the solution. Go back, pause the question, solve it yourself and see whether you can do it. And this is one way of doing it. It's my way of doing it. It's not necessarily the only way or the best way of doing it. But I have found it to be reasonably easy for most of the students I have taught. Okay. Thank you guys.